Here we're given m varies inversely as t. This is important because it tells us which variation equation to use. We'll be using the inverse variation equation, which is normally given as y equals k divided by x, where k is the variation constant. But notice how they've changed the variables for this problem. So when it says m varies, that's telling us the equation will be m equals. So whenever we see the word varies, we can write an equal sign. And then because it varies inversely as t, we'll have k divided by t. We're also told m equals 9 when t equals 6. Then we're asked to find the variation constant, the inverse variation equation, and then m when t equals 27. So to find the variation constant, we'll substitute 9 for m and 6 for t to solve for k. So we'd have 9 equals k divided by 6. Now to solve this for k, we'd multiply both sides by 6. This simplifies to 1, so we have 54 equals k, or k equals 54, which is our variation constant. Notice how what we did to solve for k is multiplied both sides of the equation by t. If we look down at our variation equations, notice how we're given x times y equals k. So to apply this here, we could have just found the product of m and t. And now for our inverse variation equation, we'll substitute 54 for k into this equation here. So we know m is equal to 54 divided by t. So again, this is our inverse variation equation. And then for the last part, we're asked to find m when t equals 27. So we'll substitute 27 for t and solve for m. So we'd have m equals 54 divided by 27, which is equal to 2. So m is equal to 2 when y equals 27.